Hey guys, it's Rob from KY Constrictors and Exotics, and today I thought I'd shoot a little video with my buddy Lucifer. And for those that don't know, Lucifer is a diffused corn snake, otherwise blood red, another name for them. They're either called diffused or blood red. Usually when they're just the single gene, they're usually called blood reds, but in combos, they're usually called diffused, if that makes more sense. Like a hypo-diffused or a diffused aneurytheristic or something. Anyways, he is about 2 years old. He is just about full grown. I'm not thinking that he's going to be growing very much more. He's about 3 foot long now, and that's typically how long adult male corn snakes get, anywhere from 3 to 4 feet. And as you can see, he is a beautiful boy. Look at that belly pattern. All that used to be like kind of a glittery black and white speckled, but it's turned reddish orange over time. And he has banding, little dark red saddles with just a hair black outline on each saddle as he gets wadded up in my tripod there. And as you can see, his throat actually has some white coming up the sides. A lot of people would say, you know, that's a low expression pied, because you do see a lot of pied mixed with the blood reds, but he's just a blood red, diffused corn. I've had him since he was a hatchling. I actually bought him for my wife, trying to get her into snakes, and she ended up trading me this guy for my bearded dragon, Luce, or Augie. Anyway, his name's Lucifer. I got him out, got his enclosure cleaned. And thought I'd share him starting this video out, but today's video is going to be about leopard geckos. So stay tuned, and I'll be right back. So since I was holding a colubrid, I thought, why not show you my albino western hognose? And he is just growing beautifully. I've had him since he was a hatchling. As you may know, or you may not know, hognose snakes are rear fanged venomous. So, not something you typically want to take a bite from, but these guys usually don't bite. They're more bluffers than anything. And they're very, very awesome snakes. I love mine to death. In his cage, he is just, I mean, a pure, demon. I mean, he will huff and puff, and he'll do fake strikes, as you see him there checking out the camera. But one thing I love about these guys is their bellies. I'm not sure the camera is going to pick up the true colors of that, but western hognose, its belly is like black, dark brown color, Well, with the yabanos being orange, their bellies are like a purplish color. Not sure if the light can pick it up. Let's see here. Adjust my focus of my light. Unwrap his tail. There we go. As you can see, his belly is quite purple and dark orange along the sides, with the very tip of his undertail being really dark orange. Anyway, they're kind of a rough keeled, scaled snake. You can kind of see him as he moves them pop up just a little. But he loves his food. And if you don't have a Western hog nose, do your research. I very much, right there is a defense mechanism. You see what he's doing there with his tail? He's digging it in, hoping that he can trick me into thinking that he's bit me. So I will let him go. So, anyway, awesome snakes. If you don't have one, I suggest getting one. But do your research and be prepared, because they are rear fang venomous. So if you're allergic to something like a bee sting, these guys can be pretty rough. I've seen pictures. They can leave a nasty bite. But with moderate handling, proper feeding, you can enjoy these guys just like I am. Anyway, I got one more colubrid I want to show you, and I'll be right back. Alright, my third and final colubrid I'm going to show you today is my Mexican black king snake, the poor man indigo. Let's trust me, I'm a poor man. I can't afford no indigo right now. So, the Mexican black king will just have to do. His name is Gonzalez. And I am looking for a mate for this fellow, preferably one closer to breeding size, because I want to start producing these little guys right here. And I'm looking for a couple mates for him. That way, you know, I have 3 to 4 clutches a year from them, because everybody loves Mexican black kings. They're quite affordable and very popular, very high in demand right now. So, why not breed them, you know? Anyway, this is Gonzalez. Mexican black kings are quite different. If you've ever owned a king snake, I mean, they're typically a king snake, just solid black. But they vary sometimes. Let me see if I can show you the underside of his jaw here. He's not going to cooperate, I don't think. Alright, let's see here. See the little white specks? When I first got Gonzalez, the whole underside of his jaw was just white. He almost looked like a very, very low white, black and white cow king, but not, I knew better. Mexican black king snakes just have that look about them. And I also knew that the pattern being underneath their mouth and on their bellies can be variable. Guys, so right here, I have my first colony. And right here is the male. He is a super hypo tangerine trimper albino. In other words, he is a sunglow gecko. And as you can see, man, that vibrant orange. He is something else. Alright. That being said, all his babies he produces are hypos. Some he has produced some hypo tangerines. He's produced hypos. Mostly hypotangerines. And if you want to know what that looks like, here is a hypotangerine. Okay, that baby is for sale, by the way. I have four of them. I'll show them here in a minute. But anyway, here is the daddy and his two mamas. Mama here, this is Chi-Chi. She is just a normal. She's a very nice looking normal, a speckled normal. But nonetheless, just a normal. And yes, whenever I picked her up, she had that up with her tail. As you know, they can drop their tails and regrow them. And now, Blondie here, she is a jungle designer. Very pretty girl. And she is also the star of many of my photos. I may insert that photo here. And I just wanted to go over my leopard geckos with you guys. Anyway, this is a Carson. He's actually my daughter Brooklyn's gecko. That's Carson. He's the papa of this colony here. This is Chi-Chi. Again, my normal female. She's given me three clutches this year. She got pretty thin on me, so I stopped breeding her for a while until she started eating. And now she's killing her food. They're in a tub. I got one male, two females. I have three hides. I have two on the hot side, one being a regular hide, one being a humid hide. As you can see, there's humidity. And one being on the cool side. They have a water dish, a food dish, and a supplements dish. This right here is a mix of vionate, herptivite, and calcium D with D3 in it. So if they feel they need supplements, then they get them. I don't dust their mealworms, because if you've ever tried dusting mealworms, it's a pain. Plus, they have their supplements dish. And when I feed their dubias to them, as you can see, they do eat dubias. They love them. But all my dubias are gut loaded with my homemade chow that I make, which is basically a blend of corn flakes with Honey Nut Cheerios for the grains. I put instant oatmeal, alfalfa powder, bee pollen, vionate, and D3 along with herptivite. All mixed up together. I'm not going to go through that. I may do a video later on how I make my dubia chow. But anyway, they're gut loaded perfectly for these leopard geckos. As you can see, she gets a pretty girl. Anyway, that's one colony. I'll show you my other one right quick. Wanted to show you how they look when they're clean. I'm in the middle of cleaning. I clean these guys about twice a week, and I'm about to show you why. Now, this is just a two gecko colony. I have a Supermax Snow right here. That's my male. Everything he produces will be snow. And then I have a white and yellow right here. That's my female. And she is such a sweetheart. Yes, she is. I love this girl. I don't have a name for her yet, but actually I don't have a name for either one of these guys. I think Lexi was wanting to name my Supermax Snow Plum Pudding because, well, he's purple. But, nah, I just don't think Plum Pudding is a good name for him. But, as you can see, food is gone. Supplements have been gone through. There's their water dish. And then, right here, if you've ever owned leopard geckos, they pick a corner and they poop in it. That's it. This is our humid hide right here. I'm going to check it for eggs just to make sure. Because as you can see, it does look like there's been some digging going on. We'll have to see. But I'm going to change your paper towel and clean your enclosure. Actually, let's go ahead and take these guys out. Come here, Professor Plum. That could be your name, Professor Plum. And I don't really know what to name her just yet. If y'all have any name ideas, look at the pattern on that. She's just awesome. Not sure if she's albino or not. Her eyes don't look like they are. But I could be wrong. I think she's just a white and yellow. I got her from PetSmart. And if you know anything about buying animals from PetSmart, they're just name normals or fancy.
That's fancy.
Anyway, let's go through, see if we got any eggs. The last of my gecko eggs hatched this morning, matter of fact. I had one hatch late last night. And the other one, I watched Pip this morning. I wish I could have got that on camera, but it is what it is. The sides of the container was just condensated so bad you couldn't really see it. And I didn't really want to make for a boring vlog of just showing a condensated container. Anyways, as you can see, they do make a mess. So if you're in the market for geckos, just be prepared because you will have to do some regular maintenance cleaning for them. Not too hard. I'll show you how hard it is right here. We'll dump out their water. Give them some fresh water. Roll this up. Take the tub, anything loose, just kind of shake it out, put it in the trash. Then, F10 on everything, guys, for real. It's a lifesaver. Just a quick little spritz. We'll let that sit for about 10 minutes. Wipe it out. That way it kills any germs. But anyway, let's look at some baby geckos here. Move my card out of the way. First off, we have the newborn. This is a Max Snow white and yellow. And as you can see, he's got some stripes on him, some nice bold stripes. Huh. I wonder if that's where they get the bold strap at morph. Huh. Pretty cool, huh? Anyway, he's a little feisty fella. He'll bark at you. See if I can bark. Trying to watch the camera in and pick him up, but no good. Got some dubias floating around. Anyway. Put him anyway. This one right here I thought was pretty cool. I mean, just look at the pattern on this guy right here. Look at that, ain't that awesome? That's another Max Snow white and yellow. And I say that because if you can look right along his back here, let me actually get him out. He's not too bad. Of course, I say that. Look how the color is coming through. You can definitely tell. Anyway, that's the pairing of these two, which is my Super Max Snow white and yellow. And we'll look at some of my Carson's babies here, my Sunglow. I got a hypo. That guy's for sale. Got another hypo. That guy's for sale. These are all temperature sex for male. Or temperature incubated for male. Here is a hypo tangerine. And as you can see, oh, he acts like it's into the earth trying to get away. They are friendly, guys. They do calm down in time. But you can see the nice purples coming through on him. The green eyes. Hypo tangerine. Oops, sorry, buddy. I gotta give them a clean and a feed. And then another hypo tangerine. As you see, they can make a mess in a few days' time. Just cleaned them last Thursday. So, 4 days ago. This guy does not eat his mealworms. He ate a few, that was it, but he likes his dubious, let me tell you. Loves his dubious. Actually, we're going to go ahead and just show you how much he loves his dubious. Do a little dubia feeding here. Sorry about the poor camera work, guys. Just takes a little while. Get me a dubia roach. And we'll see. You missed it, bud. Stop eating the paper. He's hit the paper. There you go. Give me the paper back. Did you see this? There we go. Now he's got it. He's got his dubia roach there. You can't eat paper towels, buddy. Sorry. Awesome looking guy, man. Awesome, awesome. Give him another roach here. And of course, they go hide and cover. So. Loves them dubious. Anyways, guys, I'm burning up in here, and I'm going to go ahead and finish cleaning these geckos. Hope you enjoyed my video. If you did, make sure to hit that like and subscribe button, and be good at it. Thought I would add one more thing. For my baby geckos that I have in the single tubs, you just see the plain hide, water bowl, food bowl. I don't offer all that stuff that I offer my colonies, like the human hide, the multiple hides, the supplement dish, water bowl, food bowl, all that. I don't offer that to my babies because I want to monitor, you know, their bathroom. I want to make it easier for them to hunt that way. Get them used to finding their food. Once they get bigger, I'll move them up to a bigger enclosure. And they'll have all that stuff. But as they're babies, I either keep them like this. Or put them off to the side and monitor them that way. Just want to put that in there. If any of y'all had any questions about that. I mean, we can talk about it if you have a better way to keep them and be able to monitor that much easier. Then hit me up on my email. It's in the description as always. But it is robertsowers3@gmail.com. Catch you guys on the next one.